For me, it's about a day at a time. None of us know what's around the corner and what's waiting for us. And for me, it's more important to be present and enjoying today. My name is Louise, Lou. I was diagnosed with multiple myeloma at the end of 2020. When I was first told that I had multiple myeloma, it was still a huge shock and disappointment. I very much listened to my doctor's advice and what they recommended. As time has gone on, I've asked more questions, I've researched myself into sort of treatment and different treatment options. It's always been really important for me to have all the information I can get. And I've been really lucky with my doctors in that they take time to explain myeloma and how it works and what sort of cancer it is. And so I've always felt very clear.
My name is Sarah Gooding. I'm a doctor in the NHS in the UK. I've been looking after Lou with regards to her myeloma care for maybe 3-4 years now. We have really good discussions about the treatment. She's very honest. She says what she's thinking and she doesn't pull her punches if she's fed up with the way something's making her feel. It's her body, it's her disease. It's therefore important that she has agency and ownership in deciding where we put the bar.
It's really important that the patients have somebody that they feel that they can go to. So if they don't feel that they can speak to their doctor, then there has to be other resources made available. One of the things I like to do is go to a cancer rehab class. The class is really fun and it's really supportive, and we also get to do some exercise. But the main thing is it's a group of people that have all either been through cancer or currently going through treatment. I thought it would be really beneficial to start doing a YouTube video, which I started, and I diarised and logged my journey. And I feel really passionate about sharing my story with others, because if it just helps one person, then I feel like it's been worth it. We are constantly sort of navigating blood tests, doctor appointments, follow-ups, being monitored. You know, there's a lot of anxiety around waiting for scans and waiting for the results. I think they call it scanxiety, but there's much more advancement in treatments and there's much more research going into treatments, and people are living much, much longer than they used to.
When I think about how far myeloma treatment has come since I started to specialise in haematology, the difference is staggering. The lines of treatment that we can give people now and the years people are living for now with myeloma is so completely different to what it was a decade ago.
I think so many of us spend so much time thinking about yesterday or tomorrow or rushing around that I've worked really hard just to enjoy every moment, every conversation, every time the sun shines, anything. And even though I do have myeloma, I really try not to let it define me. I always try and just be Lou, be me.